here with a few members of the Colorado Buffaloes coming off their victory over Minnesota Duluth. You guys started off a little bit slowly in that first half. Talk about the transition, though, to the second half and coming back and winning the game.
I mean, like you said, we came out slow and the whole team knew it. So we got together at halftime, talked about it, and really made it a point to come out hot and make every ground ball ours and play hard to the whistle every single time.
Yeah, you know, Minnesota Duluth, you got to give them credit. They were really possessing the ball, winning some faceoffs, and they did a great job possessing the ball, keeping it away from our offense. And when we came down, you know, their goalie, got to give him credit too. He played great, and they were great at clearing the ball as well.
You guys came out firing at first. I spoke with a few members of the team and the coaching staff before the game, and you guys have been hanging out at the hotel all day. How antsy were you guys getting leading up to this game? I mean, you have the second to last game here tonight.
You know, we were extremely antsy. That parking garage over there, you wouldn't know how many times you go up, because we were sitting on that bus, thought we were here, going up. We were very antsy. We got here a little earlier than expected because of California traffic we've all heard so much about. And we were real antsy. We'd get out there taking a ton of shots, and you know what? They just weren't falling. Goalie was playing well, but second half we were kind of placing them better, and ball went bounced our way.
We talked about you guys coming out slow in the first half. What do you think the biggest difference would be between the first and second half?
You know, we talked it over. We're settling the ball on offense. The first half, we were really coming down and shooting. We're always pushing transition, and sometimes, you know, you got to settle the ball. Our offense got a little tired from coming down, taking a shot, and riding hard, and we'd come down, take another shot, ride hard again. We were getting a little tired, so really focused on settling the ball, passing around maybe once or twice, and then getting into our offense. Our defense stepped up huge today, and you really got a hand to them. They played awesome.
Mm-hmm, that's true. And we weren't working for our best shot. We were taking the first shot, not the best shot we could have done, and all the credit to Minnesota Duluth. Their defense played great. Their goalie's thrown his head.
I think it contributed to being antsy, too. I think we were gripping our sticks a little tight. I mean, this is the first game of the MCLA tournament. Everyone knows what's going on, and Minnesota Duluth has played real tight. And I don't know. We're lucky to move on in advance, and that's all.
Tyler, in your final year of eligibility, how does it feel coming into this tournament as a number two seed and a lot of people's favorites to pick up the championship?
I mean, it feels good. We had a good year. We think we earned it. We, you know, a lot of hard work in the weight room, early mornings, practice, late nights. So it feels good to be here. It feels good to be here with all the guys that have done all that work with us. So we're very excited to be here.
Now be honest, how much scoreboard watching was going on this morning in the early afternoon?
A lot. I'm not going to lie. I watched the entire Michigan State game and up until we had to get ready. So quite a bit. I mean, the MCLA did a great job casting all those games. I was watching four at a time at one point. That Santa Barbara game was a great game, so I had my eye on that. But definitely a lot of scoreboard watching.
It's awesome just to see such good lacrosse, and the accessibility to it is amazing. It's great.
And, of course, you guys will face off against Michigan State tomorrow. What differences are you going to make between the game that was a few months ago in foot of snow and a game coming out here in Southern California?
You know, we got to play hard. They've got a great guy at the Faceoff X. We're going to have to game plan for him, try to stop him. And, you know, we got to play hard. Last time they got the best of us. You know what? They're a great team. We really got to come out firing, try to get the ball, get possessions. Defense is going to play tough. You know, we just got to do what we know what we can do.
I think shot selection is going to be key, too. Their goalie played tremendously, and he's a great goalie, and we got to shoot better and take care, make our opportunities. So,
you guys played a very physical game tonight. How do you feel like that's going to affect you going into tomorrow, the next day, after Minnesota? You know, really came out looking to go toe to toe with you guys.
I think it's gonna, you know, we'll feel it tonight, but we got a really good training staff, so we're not too worried about it. Plus, we know everybody else has played a tough game too, and throughout the season, there's been a lot of back-to-back weekends, you know, Friday, Saturday, or Saturday, Sunday games. So we've definitely experienced it before, and we're going to have to take it into consideration, get a good stretch in tonight, maybe some ice, some Advil, but we feel good about it.
Coach always says,
we
will be taking lots of ice baths.
Coach always says you can't be tired. I mean, these are the MCLA championships. This is what we play for. This is what we work for. You're not tired. You just got to play through it, and we're looking to play through it.
Got to play together.
Great, three Colorado Buffs from their win over Minnesota Duluth just moments ago.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you.